All right, my friends, welcome to another video lesson. In this lesson, we're going to be discussing how to do the color correction on the footage and images provided by our interview subject. Now, in this case here, you can see, looking at the scopes, you can see we've got a relative color balance going here, but things are a bit too bright. I mean, we're pegged up against 100 here, and that's because of this light and the lighter parts of the image being the side of this car, the floor. So we want to drop the overall exposure level on this to bring it down a bit, so it's not quite so bright. I'm going to leave the brighter parts around 90. Then I think I'm going to reduce the saturation just a little bit here, because I think we're pretty darn saturated. Maybe go down to about 90 on this. I'm gonna see what a little bit of contrast will do here. It's kind of cool. I think I like that. And there you have it. That looks pretty good. Let's try toggling on and off now. Yeah, absolutely. We brought that under control. All right, let's move on to another one. This one here, I think we're looking at relatively the same type of thing here. I'm gonna bring the exposure down slightly. And looks like we're a little heavy on the reds here, so I think I'm going to change the balance a little bit towards the blue side of things. You can see that kind of balances things out a little bit better. And we might actually need a little more saturation on this. And then we'll try some contrast as well. Nice. All right, now let's toggle on and off with that. Oh yeah, much better. The image is a lot less washed out this way. It's richer, for sure. Okay, so let's try doing an image now. Move over here to, let's try this one. Okay, so you can see in general, the image kind of has a little bit of a flat look to it. It's not as rich as it could be. I think it could probably use a little more color, some contrast. The blacks should be deeper than they are. Exposure-wise, I think it's pretty good. We've got this pinpoint of light here actually hitting 100, but it's not over, so I think it's okay. And I don't think there's a lot we can do without dropping the rest of the image too much. Maybe we can bring it down slightly. Yeah, we'll do that. We might actually be able to use an S-curve on this because it looks so flat. So let's head down to curves and try that same trick that we used with the Amira footage. Raise the top part up, bring the bottom part down and deepen and make those blacks a little more rich. Yeah, that looks a lot better, doesn't it? Okay, good. Back up to basic correction. And let's add a little more color to it. And then change the balance slightly towards the blue end of things. Bring that a little more into balance on our parade there. That looks pretty good. Let's toggle on and off to see what we've done. Oh yeah, huge difference. That looks a lot better. Very nice. All right, let's tackle one more here. This one is pretty bright. Looking at it, you can just tell it's way overexposed. All right, so I'm gonna turn off the bottom part here, our blurred background. Disable that, right click and choose enable to get rid of it. And you can see our black pillars are back. And that's because I just wanna concentrate on this image here. And then I'll take whatever I do here and apply it to the other image below. So because it's so bright, you can see on our waveform Luma here, there's a lot near 100. So I'm gonna drop the overall exposure here to begin with. Bring that down to, just below 90. And then I'm gonna increase our contrast slightly. And then let's see what saturation will do. Bring a little more color into the image. It's pretty good. I think I'm gonna drop the highlights as well. slightly. And then I'm going to try the whites here, which are the really super bright parts of the image. See if I can bring those down a little bit too. Okay. Now I'm going to change the color balance because you can see we're high on the red side. So I'm going to bring the temperature over a little bit towards the blue. That's pretty good. Now let's head down to curves and see what we can do with this sky. I think it's a little bit washed out. I'd like to see it a little more blue. So what I'm going to do is head to my hue versus saturation panel here. I'm going to select a color range using the eyedropper control here. I'll click on that and select part of the sky here that's got some blue in it. And you can see a color range appears on my control line here. And basically, this represents a range of blue that I'm able to affect. So if I drag the center control here up or down, I'm going to add or remove that range of blue from the image. So if I pull this down, you can see that the sky gets almost gray, but the rest of the image doesn't really change. That's because I've isolated just that range of blue. So now I can add to the sky and make it a little more blue without changing the color balance of the rest of the image. Kind of cool. Now, if I turn this on and off, you can see I've added some blue to that sky. Very nice. So now let's head up and toggle on and off our overall color work here. And you can see, wow, that is a huge difference in the image. It went from overexposed and kind of whitewashed to much more properly exposed with some nice rich color to it. So now I'm going to take that same profile and apply it to my background image here. Re-enable that and paste attributes. Hit OK. And now the background is much more in line with my foreground image. Now you can see the overall color balance is slightly skewed towards the blue end of things, and that's because I blued up the sky a bit. So it's okay to be out of balance if you're doing that for a purpose. Obviously, you don't want to be too far out of balance, but in this case, a slight adjustment really did help the look of that sky. All right, so that's using the Lumetri color panel to deal with the footage and images provided by our interview subject. So what I'd like you guys to do is go through and do some color work to your entire timeline, making sure that you've got proper exposure, a rich tone to the image, and a relative color balance between the three components of the video signal, red, green, and blue. Do this with your interview cameras, with all of your footage, and the still images that you've used. And I guarantee you, the overall visual appeal of your piece is going to be dramatically improved. And that about does it for this video lesson, my friends. I'll see you again in the next one.